But my view, the way in which I find, I think the reason why I hate the world, it goes all the way back to when I was a Christian, a long time ago. Then I kept some of my moral intuitions. I guess that if my morality is in from Christianity, then if one thing I like to call the world is putrid. I guess that if morality is false, or if Christianity is wrong, and there is no God, then the world we live in must be putrid. I think that's where it comes from. But it's only recently I realized that that's one of the reasons. So the world must be putrid. But if there is no, most of my thinking about morality, I do, then I don't think there is any objective morality. It's pretty hard to talk about. I think ethics and morality is pretty. I also just conflated ethics. Every time I said morality before, then I meant ethics, because it's top down. But it's just an intuition I did never lift, I think. But I guess the most correct is to say that the will is neutral. But when I met people that had a negative outlook on life, then I often thought they seemed pretty smart because. And I think it's because most people, they regard life as a good thing, and the world is a good place, more or less. Mostly they regard life as good. But then the world, some might see as a bad place, because a lot of people die, and war and there are a lot of bad things going on, starvation, but at least life is good, especially. I don't remember exactly. Also, just defining pessimism and optimism is pretty hairy. Because the colloquial definition is not the correct one when you talk about philosophy. But people that have pessimistic intuitions, I think that it's about 20% of people, and then 80% are optimistic. But I guess it makes life easier to be optimistic. So. In that sense, maybe evolution can tell something about it. I guess it's about the memetics people use also. And mostly I can't talk to people about these things, because they basically view life as good, and I'm like a heretic if I begin to talk about it as in another way. Whatever. But but systems of a system of thinking like hedonism. That's the way in which they view morality. It just ends up being assumptuous, I would say. But really, if I had a debate just with someone about whether the world is a bad place or a good place, then I don't think there's no way to conclude that discussion. And that's also why I view it as just preference. Oh. One of the claims is not more correct than the other one. Or false. But I guess I think most people who say that the world is a bad place have maybe thought more about it. And it's pretty hard to define. I tried to come up with a definition of pessimism. Both of them are pretty assumptuous, I think. It's hard to prove either position. I would say impossible. In philosophy and optimism, there is a position on optimism from Leibniz. And he said that the world is, the way he thinks optimism is that it is that the world is, it must be good because God can't do wrong, so the Christian God. And even the suffering in the world that happens, which the pessimist would be concerned with, that's ultimately it's because of a greater good. Because so the bad things that happen, it's because if the bad things didn't happen, then causally in the future, then because that bad thing didn't happen, then something worse would have happened. So if it didn't happen, then something worse would happen, because the causality the causality of something bad that happened would be worse than if it happened. So that's the position. It's pretty ludicrous, but that's the position. And then the pessimistic one, it's, I don't think there is one that's so broad. It's mostly different areas of existence. I tried understanding the distinction between the colloquial usage, but it's much more. It's not just that you feel life is bad because of your own experience. So, for example, ethicists, they would also be, they are a type of pessimists. But you can be a pessimist without being an anti-natalist. So, but mostly it's because if they have a view of negative utilitarianism, that says that there is more bad in the world than good, and that the bad things that happen carry a lot more weight than the good things. It's not exactly negative utilitarianism. But the negative utilitarianism is that it's a moral you have a moral responsibility to try to alleviate some of the bad. I think negative utilitarians, they have to, I think most of them think that the bad things that happen are more important. Like, it comes from Arthur Schopenhauer. He said something like, if you think that, he said that there must be more bad in the world compared to the good, or at least equal. And if you are in doubt of this, then compare the feelings of two animals, one of them eating the other animal. That's something like, it's really a butchering of what is it? Something like that. Yeah, so the predator that's just eating another meal, it doesn't feel the same pleasure as the pain of the other animal that's being eaten, is his point. I guess that makes more sense than the optimist one. But the way I view it is just my pessimistic view. It's just it's like a laundry list. There's someone else who said that it's because the world, or he said life is insufficient. Life is insufficient. It's imperfect. It's who is it? Arthur Arcturus or Actarius. He's a YouTuber. He's a pretty known pessimist as well. In those circles. But for me, it's just a laundry list of like all the. If you list all the bad things, like there is no objective meaning in the world, that would be maybe the highest one for me. And then you could list things like war and death and all the pain in the world, and the fact that we need to act to stay alive. All those kind of things, just everything you can think about. Injustice. There's a rabbit in the middle of the street, that road. I saw another rabbit earlier. No, it's a hare. Here. through first. I don't know, but for me it's mostly just the lack of meaning. Or aging, that would be higher on my list. The fact that every people when old age, just old age, it's worse for me than death itself. The fact that we look like corpses that are deteriorating and looking like shit when we die of old age. It's one of them. You could also say just the stupidity of people in general. Or the insufficiency of our minds. Be a good one. Oh, the necessity for us to work, but that's like another way of saying what I did already. Rape. Hatred. But, like, if you only focus on one of the things, then like, people couldn't love each other without hatred, I guess you could say. If one of them didn't exist, then I guess without the dichotomy between sympathy and antipathy, then you couldn't make a distinction. Antipathy. So, and without bad, then you can't tell what is good. It's pretty hard to just focus on one side. Like, how could there be good without the bad? It's pretty funny when the antinatalist that states that or negative utilitarians, when they say everything comes down to emotion. But there is a reductio on that that I don't think they would agree with, and that is that the best life would be maybe using some virtual reality or life and being in a machine like a matrix, like in the movie Matrix, where everything is perfect and no one can feel pain. So it's, and then you could have sex with 5 women all day, and like there's no, everything you want, and there's no, what's that, like a position between what you want and what you get inside the virtual reality. And no one else would be hurt, so even if you're a sadist, then you could just kill people and it would feel exactly right, or exactly like the reality, but it wouldn't be. And I don't think they would agree with that. They would prefer to live in that simulation. And I don't think that, I don't think most of them would agree that they would prefer like being on opioids all day and not doing anything, but you know, they would get like the highest stimulation of the brain that is possible to give. I don't think they would choose to do that either. So in a way, then even to a hedonist, then like emotion matters because it changes reality, or alters reality. And I guess the reason why things matter to some extent when you make a change in reality, then it's because it doesn't do you a bidding. It's hard to achieve anything in reality. Most things that are worth achieving takes a lot of time to achieve. It's not easy. But that follows from their core beliefs, that would follow from it, that it would be the correct answer to be connected to VR or just get stimulated by opioids all day. Both of them all day. And they wouldn't need to eat either, so they would just sustain themselves. I guess it would be like a reality where you were like God or something. Like you could just move around just by thinking it and change your shape. I don't know, but I guess that's not really pleasure. But you could do things that would give you pleasure. Like everything that would give you pleasure. Guess that's it. Really know what it means to for the world to be good or bad. It just becomes weirder to think about the more I think about it. I guess it just is. But I still want to view it as bad. I guess that's also just my choice, that I choose to view it as bad.